Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my Angular course. In the previous video, we have seen about the router link, how to keep the link navigation of the links in the routing, right? Now in this video, we will see about how to keep an active class for the selected element. So how we will be able to know that which option is being selected here. Okay, so for example, here the category works, here it is selected as category works. That means categories should be highlighted. That means we will be able to know that we are in the categories page. Okay, how we can keep that one, we will know here. Now here, if you see the links thing, now if you go here, we have some problems, so we need to add some bootstrap classes so that it will be very easy for us. So for example, here I need to add class is equal to nav-link. Okay, so in the previous video I forgot to add this bootstrap classes. If I add here nav-link, now let's see the output, how the output will be. If we see the output, fine, so these are one by one down here, it is there. Now if I want to make one link active, what I need to do, I need to add, what is happening here, one second, nothing happened, just a browser, just editor problem. Okay, fine. Now what we need to do, so if we keep this li item as active, if you see here, if you see the output, what it will happen, nothing is happening, right? So for example, I think we need to keep this one to a element, I think. So now if I see, yeah, so now we need to keep the, for anchor element, this active class. So whatever the active class we keep it, so that element will become the selected element. If you see here, now the users will become the selected element. So that means we need to add this active class, so whichever the routing is active. So how we can keep this routing, how we can keep this class for this one, so how we will be able to know. For example, if you click on users, now user should be able to know. So that means using the routing, it has to do. Okay, how we can do this one? So this can be achieved through the Angular routing itself. So Angular has provided one directive, that is nothing but router link active. So wherever you want to keep this one, router link active. Okay, you can apply to this one, or otherwise to li class also you can apply. Okay, so right now we need to add active to the anchor element, right? Router link active. What is the class you want to apply? So I need to apply the active. So if you have your own class, means you can also use my active or something like this also you can use. For us, it is an active, right? So I will be adding this active. Now copy this one and add it to all the elements. Okay, now if I add it to all the elements, now I have added this router link active. So please add a class active if ever this route is active. We are saying that if this route is selected, so please add a class active, we are writing. Now if you see here, so now fine, categories means categories is selected, users means user is selected. But if you are able to see, this home is selected all the time. Okay, when we click on home only, it should be selected. If we click on users, it should be selected, users only should be selected. What is the problem here coming? The problem is nothing. So we are getting a problem that here, if you see the routing thing, so the routing is localhost 4200/categories. That means home is nothing but what we can say is localhost/4200 only. Okay, but here categories means localhost 4000 and also the categories. That means, so what the Angular will think of it is, okay, so in this total URL, localhost 4200/// is also a part of this routing. So that means I need to enable this home also. So it will think like that. So if you go to the categories, okay, fine, categories is there, I will need to enable this categories also. Like this, it will be thinking. So whichever is a part in this one, so it will be automatically selected. So but we don't need this type of behavior. What we need is, we need to be, the route should be selected in such a way that if the path exactly matches this one. But here the home partially matches this one, slash is there and categories also is there. So but here the slash is not only is there, the categories also is there. So that means home will not be a part of this one. So if it matches exactly only, then we need to select that one. So how we can tell that one? So in the home is the only option what we are having, right? Problem. So we will be adding another directive. We have another directive, something like router link active options. Okay, so router link active options, if you see here, you'll be having router link active options. So if you go here, router link active options, so here what we need to keep is, we need to write exact, it's an object, exact to true. So we need to keep router link active options. Please select this router link whenever the URL is matched exactly. So that is the thing we are trying to say. So now if you go here and if you see, now the selection of home has been gone away. So if you select here only, the home will be selected. Why? Because it is matched exactly. Users and all those things, it is selected. Okay. So this is how we can add a class active. So to the navigation, so to know whatever the routing is selected using this router link active and also router link active options. This is how we can select the router link, active router link. So if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.